how to make a woman connect with you more intimately. This video may take you by surprise. Well, hello and welcome. My name is Erica Angelo, and I have been giving guys like you advice for over 13 years now, helping you become the kind of man that she can't resist while not losing yourself in the process or her. So if you're new here, welcome. How do you get a woman to want to connect with you more intimately? You know, for some people watching this, you may have different ideas of what that actually means. For some people, intimately means sex, right? For some people, intimately means connection, like really like having that deep connection where the two of you are really getting to know each other beyond the surface and really at the heart, at the core of one another. But the reality is that the two go hand in hand. Hey guys, no matter where you are in your journey with women, I've got you covered with one of my courses. So make sure that you check these courses out at ericaangelo.com. You see, if you're coming and you're watching this and it's about intimacy in terms of sex, here's the thing. When you want sex to be more intimate, you know, that deep connection. I'm not talking about the sex where it's like two bodies, you know, pushing up against each other. No, I'm talking about the sex where there's actual intimacy, there's passion, there's fire, there's longing, there's a burning in one in each other's eyes. There's that, I want to please you. I want to ravish you. I want to make all of your dreams come true. I want to turn you out. You know, it's like those kind of things. That's that fiery intimacy. And a lot of that gets done through what? Conversation, connecting intimately, opening yourself up. Because I always say, if you can open up a woman here in her heart, then you can open up her here, sexually, down below. Yeah, the two go hand in hand. Also, if you're new here, make sure that you subscribe and turn on the notification bell. So here's the thing. If you want real intimacy in a relationship, when it's sexually connecting through conversation, it takes one thing, and that's called vulnerability. Vulnerability, and the words of Dr. Brené Brown, who's done a TED talk about this, she's done a Netflix around this, is she says that one of the things that really identifies if you're being vulnerable is emotional exposure. It's saying those things you wouldn't say to a normal acquaintance. It's those things that you don't go sharing with the whole world because they're too precious, they're too intimate. And so when you share these things with her, there is that sense of emotionally exposing yourself. And so I know for a lot of guys, many guys want to resist this because they're afraid what? A woman's going to see them as weak. She's going to take advantage of what you share with her. Or the other thing is, how do I don't even share with women intimately because I don't know when it's too far. And so the idea of boundaries is kind of like ambiguous to you. So here's the thing though, I will answer that. But if we don't do that, what happens is we don't actually have real intimacy. When we're not having that sense of emotional exposure, it doesn't always have to be heavy. Sometimes it can be being very honest about your dreams. Just the other day, I had dinner with a friend and we were watching sunset and my friend said, Erica, like, what do you want to accomplish in life? And I said, what, in the next 3 or 4 months? He goes, no, in your life. And I took a risk in that moment because anytime that you're going to be intimate with someone, it's going to feel like a risk. It's always going to feel that way. It's going to feel like that, I'm going to jump off of a cliff here. That's what it's going to feel like. So if you feel that, that's normal. And so he said, what are your dreams? And I normally have like a list of things that I will tell pretty much everyone, but this is a friend that I have had history with. Here comes the boundaries part. This is someone I've had history with. They've been a good friend. They're a more evolved person. And so I know that when I share something with them, it's going to be respected and they're going to uphold my confidence. And those are things that you want to keep in mind when you're being intimate with her, when you're choosing to emotionally expose yourself, as Dr. Brené Brown says, and you want to share this with them, like you want to take into account like this person's character and how they show up. And so I took a big risk. It felt very uncomfortable, but I told this person what my actual ultimate dream is, which I don't tell many people at all because it's so personal to me and it really means the world to me. And so thankfully for me and my situation, this person responded really well. But you know, I've also had other people when I've shared this very intimate dream not respond so well. That's always the risk that we take. And so what I see is a lot of men absolutely avoiding intimacy because the risk is too big. What do men say? The juice isn't worth the squeeze. But the problem is when you don't bring that vulnerability, you don't have intimacy. Without vulnerability, there is no intimacy. And if you're curious, how do I even start developing this skill of vulnerability, then I've created a course for you guys. This is something that I felt very powerful about because I knew that so many men were struggling with this. And it was a big gap between why they weren't actually connecting with women who actually cared for them, why they kept attracting women who didn't care about them. There is a big lack of respect. There was a huge disconnect. And what I saw was that men had no concept of what vulnerability looked like when connecting with a woman. And therefore, women actually weren't connecting with them for the real them. It was just based off of whatever strategy where she's trying to get something out of the guy, or it's just this awkwardness, or it's the friend zone, or it's the very disconnected sex. And so I really created this program to map it out, what that looks like and how you implement that in relationships. So if vulnerability is a challenge for you, I highly encourage you to get that product. You can get it in my store. There's a comment below. I'll put it at the end of the video. There will be a little picture at the top left video. You can click there. Or, you know, YouTube puts that little I button and you can click that and I'll put it in there as well. But I really encourage you to get your hands on that. So here's the thing, that is the problem. When we don't have that level of vulnerability, there is no intimacy. And so what happens is when guys don't have intimacy in a relationship with a woman, it leaves them feeling unfulfilled. How many of you watching, have you had unfulfilling sex where you're with a woman and the sex just doesn't feel good? Why? Because it lacks connection. And you know, for some of you, maybe you don't even get to that place of having sex with her because you're too afraid to just show people who you really are. You keep showing up in this world as what you think other people want you to be. And that's where you're shooting yourself in the foot. And that's where women are disconnecting with you and why they won't connect with you intimately in the bedroom and in conversation. So when we choose not to be vulnerable and we choose to be everything else that people want us to be, what we end up creating is a huge disconnect between us and others. You create this big divide. And what happens is you ultimately never feel seen. You always feel alone and you feel a bit isolated from the rest of the world. Like you're looking through a window and everyone else is out there and you're all alone. So I really encourage you, try that vulnerability product, get your hands on it and really dive into it. But listen, guys, if you want to really connect with a woman intimately in the bedroom, in conversation, it's going to require vulnerability. There's no way to bypass it. If you want that fulfilling connection that feels good, that makes you feel alive, that makes you go, man, I'm excited to be with this girl, it's going to require vulnerability. Remember, guys, you have what it takes. And know that in this very moment, my darling, that you are so loved. If this video really resonated with you, make sure that you give it a little thumbs up and also tell me in the comment section below which part of this spoke to you the most. I can't wait to see you guys in my next video. You take care.